Why do you think that politics worked better in 1981 versus today?
Look, there were certainly a lot of flaws in the system even then. I've heard. I wasn't alive then. You know how it is. But from the depths of my 25 years of wisdom, you know, take a look at the present situation. There was the Gephardt Rule, passed in 79, in place up until 2005, that automatically raised the debt ceiling to accommodate the spending for a given year, which is the logical, no-nonsense approach to this. The level of brinksmanship absolutely has increased since then. I think that it's about the kind of candidates that have come in both parties. And honestly, the media shares some of the responsibility for that. There is more of a market for extremism. And that's a problem. And I think my generation, our generation, is going to pay a heavy cost for that.
What do you think is lacking in the relationship between President Obama and John Boehner versus Tip O'Neill and Ronald Reagan?
I mean, people are constantly saying, oh, if only they would talk more, if only there were negotiations. I don't think President Obama getting a taco with John Boehner is going to solve the problems. I think they're fundamental. I think it's about the nature of where the two parties have gone. And, you know, I think that we're going to need very fundamental, sweeping changes to the kinds of candidates that get in if we want to see that change. The relationships aren't enough. Although, this book is important in that it does chronicle a time in which the relationships were obviously a lot stronger. That can be part of it. I just think there need to be systemic fixes as well.
Do you think there's a way back to a more collegial time in Washington or a way forward? I mean, what do you...
Again, I think it's about the type of people that get to Washington. And particularly post-Citizens United, there are a lot of people that come in on waves of huge super PAC money, which can be manipulated because essentially elections can now be bought and sold in the wake of that decision. And that is scary. It means that there isn't as much of a requirement for moderation. I think that the hope lies in people our age waking up to that, as I think they are now, given the current crisis, and pushing harder for a more moderate brand of candidate.